Hyperacusis or recruitment? Were you as confused about this as I was? I'm no medical professional. I'm just like you, a person with hearing loss trying to figure it all out. And Dr. Google is no help. There are too many opinions and variations to choose from. What do you have? What do I have? During my research on this, even in forums where I asked questions, some recipients' answers actually conflicted with medical and scientific definitions. This is where we really have to take a leap of faith and trust our own team of health professionals. Hopefully, like mine, your quality of life is your health professional's goal, and they're not just looking for another excuse to sell you up to a new device. Yes, they exist. And sadly, I have met a few. Salespeople preying on your medical condition rather than health professionals focused on your well-being. So let's take a look at the difference between hyperacusis and recruitment. Hyperacusis is discomfort from sound. What is considered a normal volume is too loud for someone with hyperacusis. You are super sensitive to what is simply normal to everyone else. It ranges from a person who is mildly uncomfortable in a crowded restaurant to a person who has severe discomfort to many of the sounds encountered in daily life, or a specific sound like a phone ringing. The thing is, with hyperacusis, you must have normal or acute hearing for at least some sounds. On the flip side, recruitment. Recruitment occurs when you have a hearing loss and you're intolerant of some sounds. Recruitment is when we think sound gets too loud, too fast. It's a rapid growth of perceived volume, with a sound or frequency located in the region of someone's sensorineural hearing loss. It occurs as a result of damage to the outer hair cells in the cochlear, and is often seen in people who have noise-induced hearing loss. For example, I jump out of my chair, startled because I perceive that my family are yelling at me. But they have actually been trying to get my attention for some time. Dad. 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 One minute I can't hear them, and then next they appear to be yelling at me. They said Dad the first time at a normal conversational level, and then they increased the volume slightly, and then again. And pow, I hear it as being yelled at, but I heard nothing until that third attempt. So if you have severe recruitment, when a sound becomes loud enough for you to hear it, in some cases, it's already too loud for you to stand. Another symptom is that what you hear is simply distortion. Even wearing hearing aids simply amplifies distortion rather than giving you clarity or increased volume. For many people with severe recruitment, hearing aids make some sounds too loud to the point it hurts. Also, hearing aids cannot correct the result of our poor discrimination. We still hear gibberish. The good news is, every cochlear implant recipient that I spoke to on Facebook or in a forum reported that both their tinnitus and recruitment, some said hyperacusis, was significantly better and in some cases gone altogether post-surgery. A well-published audiologist confirmed with me that I shouldn't get recruitment with a cochlear implant, because a cochlear implant provides you with electrical stimulation, so it's not using the same pathway that sound travels from your hearing aid. Bingo! That means that recruitment isn't actually possible anymore. That alone is hope for the future. Let's connect on Facebook at My Cochlear Journey. Until next time, take care.